We are going to learn about benchmarking. So since we have already installed Redis on one of the machines, so we will see what is the read and write performance which we are going to achieve. And I will let you know how we are going to do that. Okay, so before that, what I have done is I have logged into a machine. So I have closed previous sessions and I have opened a new session now. And currently I am in /home/redisadmin directory. So as you know, to connect to Redis CLI, you need to type redis-cli, and since we have installed Redis server on port 6370, we also need to pass port explicitly by specifying -p. So once I do that, I should be able to log into Redis server. So what do you think? Will I be able to log into Redis server, or will I be able to connect or not? Let's check that. So as you see, again I'm getting the error that Redis CLI is not found. Okay, as I told you in previous session that our Redis utilities are under here under src directory. So in the previous session we had also set up the path, okay, and then we were able to run redis-server or redis-cli or any utility which is under src directory. We were able to run that utilities from anywhere. But now what has happened is, since that command which we ran, that is only session specific, okay, so that path variable which we had set up, that was only session specific. So when I closed that session and I opened a new session, so whatever changes which were there has actually gone, because that was session specific. So in this kind of situation, what you need to do is, if you want to make that permanent, you actually go to your home directory. So the way to do that is cd /tilde and press enter. So you'll be going back to your user's home directory. Now here, if you are using bash shell, you'll be having something like bash_profile. It is not .bash-profile, it is .bash_profile. Okay, you see I have this file which actually exists. So whenever you log into a server and you are using a bash shell, so by default, as soon as you log in, whatever is inside this file, operating system executes whatever the command which you have put inside this file. So what I will do is, whatever command which we had ran previously, I will put that here. Okay, so if you remember, we had put export path equal to $path, and then we have put the complete a path of until the source directory. So it was /home/redisadmin/redistable/src. Okay, so I'm not going to make any other changes. I have just added this line. Now what it does is, so when I log into, when basically I log into this user again using any other session, then those piece of code which I had put under .bash-profile, that is going to be executed first. So when I log in, I'm going to feel like, that command has already been executed, and I'll be able to run redis-server or redis-cli utility directly. So let's do that. Let's open a new shell. So I'm going to right click and going to duplicate session. Okay, by default I am logged in with some other user, so I will switch to the user using which we have installed Redis. Okay, right now you can see I'm into /home/redisadmin directory. Now if I do redis-cli -p 6370, So now I'm successfully able to connect to Redis server. So now you know how to make your, you know, whatever command you are running, if you want to, if you put that into .bash profile, that is going to be the first thing which is going to be executed. And then, so basically whatever path you want to set, you can put that there, and then that is going to be the first thing which is going to run, and you'll be able to run all the other utilities which is inside that path from anywhere or any directory. Okay, so let's do keys star. So we know this is the things which we have put there. So I'm just exiting from here, and yeah, the way to do that is exit and hit enter. There's no semicolon required. So right now we are into Redis admin directory. So if I go inside Redis hyphen stable hyphen src and I do ls hyphen lrt, you will also notice we have something called Redis hyphen benchmark utility. So this is a utility which you can use to benchmark performance in your environment. So the first thing is you install Redis in the way which is going to be, you know, like production like, and then you can run this Redis hyphen benchmark to benchmark the performance. So what it does is it is going to execute a set of operations, okay, using some dummy data, and you can define the set of operation you want to do, or you can define the size of the data which you are going to read or write, and you can also define the number of records which you want to read or write, and based on that it will be able to let you know the performance which you are going to achieve from this Redis instance. Okay, so let me go to this documentation. Now the easiest thing to do is you can just run Redis benchmark using this command. Okay, so okay, this is the previous session which we had opened. So let me close this session. This is not going to work here. And yeah, let me come back here. Okay, so what this is going to do is actually it is going to run Redis benchmark utility in a quiet mode, and also it is going to pass 100,000 records, and based on that it is going to benchmark the performance which we are going to achieve. So let's hit enter and let's try to understand what it does. Alright, so right now it has actually given us connection refused error. The reason being is that by default this utility also tries to connect to 6379 port, and since we have changed the port, we should have also passed port explicitly. So I'm going to run this command like this. And also, let's say if you want to pass the host name, you can actually do hyphen h and pass the host name. So if your, you know, Redis is running on some other server, you can use hyphen h to give the host name, and then hyphen p to give the port name, and then hit enter. Okay, so you can see this is running, and what it is doing is all the set of commands which are available under ping, which are actually available under Redis, it is running those commands and trying to show us the, you know, number which we are achieving. So these are the different commands which are available in Redis. Okay, so we can perform set operation, we can perform get operation, we can perform increment operation, we can perform left push operation, we can perform right push operation. So what this utility is doing is it is running all of these different set of commands, and it is running on 100,000 records, and then it is telling us the performance which we are going to achieve. So basically in the set command, or that is the way to write anything or any key value pair in the Redis database, so we are achieving something around 42,000 requests per second. Okay, so again, considering the resources which I have, this is very high performance which I am able to get. So just to show you, if I run free hyphen h command, this is the number of RAM which is available right now on my machine. Okay, so you can see this machine is actually having only total 3.5 GB of RAM, out of which 1.9 GB is already used and free is only 548 MB. So if your machine is actually a production like machine, so you are going to achieve more number of, you know, reads or writes or other operations performance. So whenever you install Redis in your environment, you can use Redis benchmark utility to test this. Okay, now let's say we want to change these parameters, and we know that each record or each key value pair in our case is going to be of n number of bytes. Okay, so we can simulate that as well. So the way to do that is, okay, so just follow this document, actually you will be able to understand. Now if I come here and if I see this command Redis hyphen benchmark, or probably you can go back to, you know, in the beginning, and here you can see there is something called hyphen d parameter, and using this I can specify the data size of set and get value in bytes. So basically what I am telling to Redis is that each record is going to be of these many bytes. Okay, so let me run this one, and let's say I am telling Redis that each of my record is going to be of 10 bytes. Okay, so that's the way I do it. So you specify hyphen d followed by space and followed by the number of bytes. So 10 is going to be 10 bytes. So by default it runs with 2 bytes. So previous operation which we have ran, it ran using default number, so which means it was assuming that the byte or total number of bytes which going to be in each record is 2 bytes. Okay, so now let's run this, hit enter. Okay, so basically it is going to run the same way which it ran previously and going to show us the number. So I do not see any significant change, you know, by changing the number from 2 bytes to 10 bytes in my case. But once you have a real number, let's say you have a real size of your key value pair, that can be probably 100 bytes, and then once you execute with that number, you will be able to get the actual benchmarking. And let's assume that we also know the kind of operation we are going to run in Redis. You know, there is you are not going to run all of these commands in all the environments. So probably in most of the scenarios you are just going to run get or set command. Okay, so you are going to write the value to Redis DB and going to read the values from Redis DB. So in those cases we don't need to benchmark on all of these operations. We can actually specify to run only get or set operations. So now the way to do that is, so here you see we have something called hyphen t, which specifies the, you know, command which you want to run. So with a comma separation you can pass the list of test cases which you want to test, and then it will be running only those test cases. So if I go back and if I specify hyphen t and if I type get comma set, so in this case it is only going to run get and set operation. So let's hit enter. And you can see it ran only get and set operations, and then it exited because we had specified it to run only get and set operation and do the performance benchmarking. Okay, so hyphen n basically specifies the total number of requests which you want to you know, test with. So by default, or right now we had actually given 100,000. So if you want to test probably on 1 million record, we can change this value to 1 million. Okay, and then this is going to take a bit longer because now it has to test 100 or I'm sorry, now it has to test 1 million records. So it is going to read and write 1 million records in Redis and then going to give us the performance. So I'm not going to run this now. I just wanted to show you that if you need, you can do that way. And also if you know that how many number of applications or number of clients which are going to access Redis database in parallel, you can also specify number of expected client by providing hyphen C. So let's say I know that any point of time there are going to be, you know, maximum of 5 connections which are going to be run in parallel. You know, those are the 5 connections which are going to perform read or write operations from Redis database. So with hyphen C option, I can specify that. And now it is going to create 5 client and then going to test this. So let's see what is the performance which we achieve. Okay, actually I had also increased the number of records which it is going to test, so I had changed that to 1 million. So now it is performing the test on 1 million records and with client of 5. So it is assuming there are 5 parallel clients which are going to access or perform read or write operations, and there are total going to be 1 million requests. So it is simulating that and going to tell you the, you know, performance which is going to achieve with these conditions. So you can already see, so probably this time we have not achieved what we have achieved previously. We are now only able to achieve somewhere around 38,000, you know, read or write per second. Also there is something called hyphen R, okay, which actually specifies the number of random keys which it is going to test, you know, Redis is going to test this performance with. So when you specify something like hyphen R 100, so in this case, even though it is going to perform, you know, 1 million queries, which is based on the value which is specified here after hyphen n, it is actually going to create only 100 unique keys, and then it will be performing read or write operations. So if you want to test based on, let's say, 1 million unique keys, you can specify those number by providing hyphen r and the number here. Okay, so let me test it on a lower value. I'm just going to probably give only 1000, and here I'm going to give 1000 unique keys. Okay, since the value set or the test set which I given was very smaller, so we got the result very fast. Now I'm going to connect to Redis by using Redis hyphen CLI. And I forgot, I also need to specify the port. So guys, again, if not required, do not change the default port from 6379 to other ports, because otherwise you need to specify the port number every time. So now if I do db size, it is going to give me the total number of records which are available in database right now. So right now we have around 957 records. These are the records which got created by all the tests which we performed. And let's say we want to just flush everything which is there. So for that one, we use flush all command, please be very careful in terms of using this command. This is going to clean up everything which is there in Redis database. Okay, so right now we have 957 records. If I do flush all, it is just going to clear everything. So be very, very careful. This is a very destructive command and it runs very fast. It just clears up, you know, millions of or billions of records in very short time. So you saw I just ran flush all. Immediately I got the output. Now if I do db size, I do not have anything stored in my database. Okay, so once you do the performance testing, you can actually do the cleanup. So all the test data is removed.